Jaya Raja Madhava Kunjani Hari
Jaya Raja Madhava Kunjani Hari
Jaya Raja Madhava Kunjani Hari
Jaya Raja Madhava Kunjani Hari Narayanam namaskritya Naram
chaiva narottamam Devim sarasatim vyasam Tato jaya mudirayat Nasta prayeshu vavadreshu Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya Bhagavati Uttama Shloke Bhaktir Bhavati Naishtaki reading Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 10, Chapter 24, entitled Worshipping Govardhan Hill. This morning, text number
23.
Rajasa Chodita Megha.
Rajasa
Chodita Megha.
Rajasa Chodita Megha.
Vasanti Ambani Sarvata.
Vasanti Ambani Sarvata.
Vasanti Ambani Sarvata.
Vasanti Ambani Sarvata.
Rajas Tai Eva Siddhyanti.
Rajas Tai Eva Siddhyanti.
Rajas Tai Eva Siddhyanti.
Rajas Tai Eva Siddhyanti.
Mahendra Kim Karishyati.
Mahendra Kim Karishyati.
Mahendra Kim Karishyati.
Mahendra Kim Karishyati.
Rajasa Chodita Megha.
Rajasa Chodita Megha.
Vashanti Ambuni Sarvata.
Vashanti Ambuni Sarvata.
Rajastha Eva Siddhyanti.
Rajastha Eva Siddhyanti.
Mahendra Kim Karishyati.
Mahendra Kim Karishyati.
Rajasa Chodita Megha.
Rajasa Chodita Megha.
Vashanti Ambuni Sarvata.
Vashanti Ambuni Sarvata.
Rajastha Eva Siddhyanti.
Rajastha Eva Siddhyanti.
Mahendra Kim Karishyati.
Mahendra Kim Karishyati. Rajasa Chodita Megha.
Rajasa Chodita Megha.
Vashanti Ambuni Sarvata. Rajanta Eva Siddhyanti. Mahendra Kim Karishyati.
Rajasa Chodita Megha.
Rajasa Chodita Megha.
Vasanti Ambuni Sarvata.
Vasanti Ambuni Sarvata.
Rajasa Eva Siddhyanti.
Rajasa Eva Siddhyanti.
Mahendra Kim Karishyati.
Mahendra Kim Karishyati. Rajasa Chodita Megha.
Rajasa Chodita Megha. Vasanti Ambani Sarvata.
Vasanti Ambani Sarvata.
Prajasya Eva Siddhyanti.
Rajasya Eva Siddhyanti.
Mahendra Kim Karishyanti.
Mahendra Kim Karishyanti.
Rajasa Chodita Megha.
Rajasa Chodita Megha.
Vasanti Ambuni Sarvata.
Vasanti Ambuni Sarvata.
Rajasa Eva Siddhyanti.
Rajasa Eva Siddhyanti.
Mahendra Kim Karishyati.
Mahendra Kim Karishyati. Rajasa.
Rajasa.
By passion.
By passion.
Chodita.
Chodita.
Impelled.
Impelled. Kuta.
Mega.
Mega.
The clouds.
The clouds.
Vashanti.
Vashanti.
Pour down.
Pour down. Kimse.
Ambuni.
Ambuni.
Their water.
Their water.
Sarvata.
Sarvata.
Everywhere.
Everywhere.
Don't you?
Raja.
Raja.
The population.
The population.
Yanhao.
Tai.
Tai.
By that water.
By that water. Ta de soi.
Eva.
Eva.
Simply.
Simply.
Dan dan.
Sidyanti.
Sidyanti.
Maintain their existence.
Maintain their existence. Why hai ta mo de chun chuan.
Maha Indra.
Maha Indra.
The great Indra.
The great Indra. By that the Indra.
Kim.
Kim.
What?
What?
Some more.
Karishyati.
Karishyati.
Can do.
Can do. Lan zhou.
Purport or translation. Impelled by the material mode of passion, the clouds pour down their rain everywhere, and by this rain, all creatures gain their sustenance. What has the great Indra to do with this arrangement?
伟大的Indra跟这一安排有什么关系？Purport
by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami, Srila Prabhupada. Lord Krishna continues His mechanistic explanation of existence, concluding, Mahendra Kim Karishyati. Who needs the great Indra, since the rain sent by the clouds, which in turn are impelled by the mode of passion, is actually producing everyone's food. The word sarvata indicates that the clouds magnanimously send their rain even on the ocean, rocks, and barren land where there is no apparent necessity for such sweet water.
既然雨水由被激情屬性驅使的雲朵灑下，而真正生產出眾生食糧的是雨水，那誰還需要偉大的Indra？梵文道處Swata一詞表明，雲朵大方地讚賞其雨水，甚至送給海洋岩石和不毛之地等，顯然並不需要這種甘甜雨水的地方。
Om Agyanatimarandasyagananjanashalakaya Chakshurumbindikanyena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Panchakalpatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhubhayevacha Patitanam Pavanevyo Vaishnavevyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadha Shri Vasadi Gaura Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare.
So we're hearing how Lord Krishna is arguing with his father about the performance of the Indra Yagya. Nanda Maharaj was explaining to his son Krishna that this is a custom in our family, that we do this every year.
咁咧，咁馬拉斯咧就向佢兒子Krishna咧就解釋佢話：呢個咧係我哋家庭嘅一個習俗嚟講，我哋每一年都需要咁做嘅。Some
things are done according to scriptures, and some things are done according to tradition.
咁有啲祭祀咧就係根據嗰啲經典所教導嘅去做啦，有啲咧就係其實係根據文化嘅習俗。
In this particular case, it appears Nanda Maharaj and the Brijbasi people were inspired by their tradition.
Nanda Maharaj就同Braja的居民，咁佢哋咧就係由於受到呢一個咁嘅傳統嘅咁嘅啟示而去咁做嘅。
We often see people worshipping gods because it's a tradition, it's part of their family tradition.
咁我哋見到啲人崇拜神咧，有時咧就係都係因為佢哋家庭有啲咁嘅傳統嘅。
They often don't know why. They don't know fully any reason or philosophical reason behind it, but they do it because they have been taught by their forefathers.
咁其實佢哋好多時咧都係唔知道個原因點解咁做嘅，但係因為佢哋都係受到佢哋嘅先祖輩們咁教導，所以嚟做。
Now worship of the demigods is not totally condemned.
咁去崇拜半神人咧，其實都唔係咁被譴責嘅一件事。
It is part of the Vedic path.
咁呢個其實都係一個偉大嘅路途上面嘅其中一種方法。
The idea in the Vedas is that one will begin worshipping demigods and gradually one will understand that the result of worshipping demigods is limited and temporary.
咁喺偉大嘅教導咧，其實咧都講呢個崇拜半神人咧，其實咧就佢都係會有益處嘅，但係咧就會讓人知道咧，其實佢呢個益處係非常之係有限制嘅。
Expected that one would go on to inquire about what one has to do to achieve eternal benefit. Here in this particular case, Lord Krishna was preaching to special people.
咁喺今次呢個咁特別嘅呢個事件當中咧，Krishna係向一啲特別嘅人咧，去俾佢哋教導。The
people of Vrindavan, headed by his own father Nanda
Maharaj。就係呢個温達文娜嘅居民啦，而佢哋嘅首領咧就係爸爸Nanda Maharaj。
Nanda Maharaj is one of his eternal associates.
Nanda Maharaj 係 Krishna 嘅其中一個永恆嘅呢個同友。
Whenever Krishna comes, then Nanda and Yashoda are the parents.
咁每一次 Krishna 就降臨嘅時候咧，咁Nanda咧同埋 Yashoda 咧，佢哋都係以一對嘅形式顯現嘅。
So Krishna wanted to correct the mood of the devotees in Vrindavan.
咁Krishna 咧就希望去滿。
He doesn't want them to worship the demigods. Because they're expected to know better, they're expected to understand who is the Supreme Lord.
其實呢，佢呢就希望佢哋係了解到邊個先至係至尊主。
So this was one reason why Lord Krishna is talking against Indra.
呢個咧就係其中一個原因啦。咁點解咧 ？Krishna 咧會講出一番嘅教導咧，就係去對抗呢一個 Indra 嘅。And
another reason why Lord Krishna is explaining this kind of mechanistic or atheistic philosophy is because of Indra's pride.
咁第二個原因咧 ，Krishna 點解要講及呢個機械論，或者呢個無神論咧？其實都係想要打擊Indra嘅呢個驕傲。Indra
had become very proud of his position.
Indra 咧，佢變得係非常之驕傲於佢自己嘅權位。And
Lord Krishna doesn't like to see his devotees become proud.
咁 Krishna 咧就唔喜歡見到佢嘅奉獻者變得驕傲。
Pride is one of the qualities of the asuras, not devotees.
驕傲咧，其實係啲惡魔嘅其中一個品質嘅，並唔係奉獻者應該有嘅。
And devotees are expected to be humble.
奉獻者咧就係其實係需要被有呢個謙卑。But
that's too difficult for someone like Indra in his position. Very hard to be humble.
呢個咧，其實對於 Indra 有咁嘅權位嚟講咧，其實係非常之難去變得謙卑嘅。Indra
means king.
Indra 咧實質嘅意思咧就係解國王咁解。So
kings are not usually humble. Typical
for kings to be humble. 國王一般嚟講咧都唔會係點謙卑法。
Anyway, Lord Krishna wants to correct his mentality. We will see Indra had become so proud that he did not want the people to give up his worship. And he did not recognize Krishna as the Supreme Lord. He'd become offensive towards Krishna. This will all be revealed later when we see when Krishna stops the Indra Yagya and tells them to worship Govardhan Hill.
It said,
pride comes before the fall. When a person is proud, then they will fall down. And Indra fell down.
其實當我們在墮落之前就是這個驕傲，我們就看到Indra他是低墮了下來的。
He became angry and then he made offense.
因為他變得憤怒，所以他就變得非常之冒犯的。
And he tried to kill all the Brijbasi people.
他想殺害所有的Brijbasi的居民。
Anyway, Lord Krishna is saying to Nanda Maharaj that you don't need to worship Indra. This Mahindra, great Indra, big Indra, you don't need to worship him. And Krishna gives an argument. Why? He says, you can see the rain is falling everywhere. It's nothing to do with Indra. Krishna is saying it's due to the mode of passion. So Krishna is arguing against, he's presenting this philosophy. Just like people when things go wrong, they will say, well, it's my karma. Sometimes we'll say it's karma, sometimes we'll say, well, it's the modes of nature. The modes of nature must be very strong today, therefore I'm acting like this. So here Krishna is using both of these arguments to Nanda Maharaj. First, he was talking about karma. And said it's all due to karma. And now he's saying it's all due to the modes of nature. And which mode of nature? Particularly, it's due to the mode of passion. Due to the mode of passion, you get rain. Everything is created by the mode of passion. So this rain is also the result of the mode of passion. Of course, it may appear like that. It appears like that. But we should understand there's somebody behind the modes of nature. And just like karma, the law of karma, there must be somebody behind that law of karma. If there are laws of karma, there must be a lawmaker. But we just think, oh, it's due to my karma. We should recognize there's a personality behind this, behind everything. But the, you know, atheistic people, they don't look behind, they only look on the surface.
那些無神論的人,他們是不會看到背後的人,他們只是看到面前前面的事情。
Just like you see puppets in the theater, some puppet theater, you see the puppets move. And so, we should understand there has to be somebody behind pulling the strings on the puppets.
就好像在劇場上,我們看到那些扯線的木偶,它在動的時候,其實我們應該知道,是背後是有人拉這些繩,令到這些木偶去動。
So in the same way, behind this material world, there's also some higher intelligent beings. So Nanda Maharaj's people, they recognize Indra as being the higher intelligence behind the universe.
其他人們都知道有一個Indra,有一個比較更高級智慧的人物在背後。But
Indra is only one tiny part of the administration behind the universe.
但在這個宇宙的管理當中,其實Indra只是負責一小部分。
There are 33 crore demigods.
总共有三千三百万。
So, Indra is simply one of these.
Indra只是其中之一个。
So there are so many higher beings, but there's above all of these higher beings is one supreme being.
当然在这些高等生物体上面有一个比他们更加高的至尊的这个生物体。
And that one supreme being, that is the supreme Lord Vishnu or Krishna.
这个至尊生物体就是至尊的Vishnu或者叫做至尊的Krishna。
So Krishna wants at least the people in Vrindavan there to be aware of who is actually behind everything.
那Krishna就希望他們更加警覺到究竟是這個宇宙之後是誰是至尊。Actually,
the Nanda Maharaj and the gopis, the gopas, the cowherd people, they're not so materially educated people, they're simple people.
Nanda Maharaj 再加上那些木偶郎、木偶姑娘等等，因為他們都不是一些受過很多教育的，他們只不過是一些簡單的人。But
their qualification is that they're all devotees.
但因為他們的品質上面全部都是奉獻者的品質。And
their devotion is meant to be solely for Lord Krishna.
那他們的奉獻其實都只是為了Krishna而已。
So Lord Krishna doesn't want to see them giving some of their devotion towards Indra. You give the example, when you water the tree, you put the water on the root, not on the leaves and branches.
就好像舉了個例子,就好像當我們去淋樹的時候,都是淋它的根部,就不是淋它的枝幹或者葉。
So it's Lord Krishna who is the root of the existence of this whole creation.
我們就知道Krishna就是整個創造的根源。
If you just simply water the leaves and branches, the leaves will fall off, the tree will not grow.
所以如果我們只是將那些水淋去那些葉枝幹上面，那棵樹的葉會跌落，而且那棵樹不會生長到。It's
worship of Krishna which is important, not worship of Indra.
所以崇拜Krishna是更加重要的，就並不是去崇拜Indra。
Now, there are many parts of the world you go and you'll find people are worshipping demigods. In Malaysia, we see also like the Indian people, mostly Tamils from South India, and they all worship demigods, they have that custom.
咁啦，好似喺馬來西亞嗰度咧，咁好見到好多咧南印度人叫做查摩嘅嗰啲人咧，咁佢哋咧都係崇拜半神人嘅。
So when they are introduced to Krishna consciousness, then it is something a little different for them.
咁當佢哋咧就去知道Krishna之個時候咧，佢發現咧就同佢哋平時嘅係有啲唔同嘅。
So they're often wondering, can we keep worshipping the demigods and also worship?
咁佢哋咧就會話啦，咁我可唔可以同時咧崇拜半神人咧？當我又崇拜Krishna嘅時候。
So of course they can continue to worship all of these demigods, but they should understand they're not supreme.
當然佢哋係可以咁樣做嘅，但係咧佢哋必須要知道咧，邊一個先至係至尊。
And there are some people who worship demigods, but they worship them understanding they were parts of the body of the Supreme Lord.
咁有啲人咧就係崇拜半神人嘅，咁佢哋所認知理解嘅咧就係佢係至尊神嘅身體嘅某一個部分。So
we're not against the worship of demigods, we respect also demigods.
咁我哋咧就係咪反對去崇拜呢啲半神人嘅？
But we understand their position in relation to Krishna.
但係咧，我哋必須要知道咧，佢哋嘅位置咧，同埋同 Krishna 之間嘅關係。
In relation to the Supreme Lord, they're his tiny parts and parcels.
咁同至尊主嘅關係嚟講咧，其實佢哋係一個微小不可分割嘅部分嚟嘅啫。
So, we ask Prabhupada, which is better? Like people who are Christian, they worship, they think of God, God the Father, they understand there's one God, and they worship God. And, or who's better, some Indian who worships some demigods.
咁其實咧都會有提問，就係邊一樣好啲咧？就好似嗰啲基督徒啦，咁佢哋咧就係會崇拜呢個天父啦。咁啊，另外咧，有啲印度人咧就係崇拜嗰啲半神人。
So Prabhupada explains that actually he said when they worship the demigods it's better because they're on the Vedic path and they will eventually come to understand the Supreme Lord.
咁Srila Prabhupada嘅答案咧就係話，崇拜半神人嘅更加好，因為呢一個係一個偉大嘅路途上邊嘅其中嘅一部分嚟㗎。咁佢哋慢慢咧就會更加進步去認識到至尊主。
The Christian women, they may never come to understand. So it's better to be on the Vedic path, but at the same time, you don't want to get entangled and give all your devotion to some demigod.
當然呢個咧係比較好㗎，喺一個偉堂嘅路途上邊啦。但係咧，我哋就要警醒咧，就唔係將我哋嘅奉愛咧就交咗俾其他嗰啲半神人。One
time in Hyderabad, when they were opening the temple in Hyderabad for our ISKCON, a devotee suggested to Prabhupada that we should put a Shiva Linga there.
咁咧就喺Hyderabad呢個印度呢個地方嘅時候，ISKCON咧就開一間廟嘅時候咧，咁有啲奉獻者咧就建議Srila Prabhupada就話應該將 Shiva Linga 咧就係設立嘅。He
said if we put the Shiva Linga there, it will bring many people to worship because he said not so many people are familiar with the deities which we have.
咁當時咧，啲門徒嘅意思咧就係話，如果你擺咗 Shiva Linga
咧，就會吸引好多崇拜者啦，因為其實我哋依家崇拜緊嘅神像咧，並唔係好多人認識嘅。
Okay.
So. in Hyderabad, for we have deities of Gornitai and Jagannath Baladev, Subhadra and Radha Krishna. So certainly people are more familiar with Shiva, and you know many people they are great devotees of Shiva. Lord Shiva even has a benediction that his temples will be more than Krishna. That benediction was given by Krishna himself. Krishna likes to see his devotees glorified. But Prabhupada, however, said, no, he said, if we put Lord Shiva here, he said, then people will think it's all the same. They will think all the gods are one. No difference between Shiva and Krishna. This is what happens in the Mayavadi temples.
當然在這個Mayavadi的廟就會是這樣的。
You see, all the gods are there.
看到那裡所有神都擺在那裡了。
And which one is the supreme? Well, they're all the one.
都是一的,他們都不知道誰是至尊的。
So Srila Prabhupada did not encourage this.
雖然Prabhupada是不鼓勵這樣做的。
And similarly here, you see, Lord Krishna is not encouraging, he's not allowing the Vrishvasi people to worship Indra. Krishna temples are for pure devotion, and pure devotion means 100% devoted to Krishna.
Okay,
any questions?
How can we understand the difference while you're speaking about Krishna wants his devotees to be glorified, and then how about the
We explained that Vrindavan is a very special place. It's a place for the devotees of Krishna. At least in Vrindavan, the mood should be to worship Krishna.
咁我哋就要同啲人解釋啊，Vrindavan係一個非常之特別嘅地方啊。咁呢一個地方係需要一個心水咧，就係去崇拜Krishna。For
the ordinary people, let them worship Shiva.
咁對一般人講咧，都可以俾佢哋崇拜Shiva。And
gradually try to bring them to Krishna consciousness.
咁慢慢咧，就當然係帶到呢一班崇拜Shiva嘅人，帶到佢哋去Krishna。
If they respect Shiva as a devotee, then they should want to know who is he a devotee of.
咁如果佢哋係尊重Shiva係一個 devotee 嘅話，咁佢哋應該知道咧，佢究竟係邊一個嘅奉獻者咧。
Right, he's a great devotee. Who is he? Who does he worship? He worships Krishna.
一個偉大的奉獻者，咁佢崇拜邊位咧？咁佢就係崇拜 Krishna。
You can worship, if you worship Shiva as a devotee, there's no harm.
所以 Prabhupada's mission is Nirvishesha Shunyavadi as Chacha Devatari, to preach the message of Lord Chaitanya to defeat impersonalism and voidism.
使命就是像Lord Chaitanya所说的，其实我们就是要去摧毁那些虚无主义和非人格主义，而是崇拜至尊主义。
Because the thing is, you know, when I'm watching these serials, are made from something called Shiv Purana, another scripture. So people who are devoted to Lord Shiva, they would definitely always read Shiv Purana. And according to that, it says Lord Shiva is devoted to himself because he considers himself to be the supreme. And Lord Vishnu is below him. So, I mean, how does one... cannot relate to a person or cannot talk to a person like that because they're firm on what they, and they say it's based on what they read in the scripture, it's not heard from anywhere.
Yes, well, there are different Puranas for different people. Mm-hmm. So for people who are in the mode of ignorance, then they can worship, they can read like Shiva Purana, they can read these kind of things.
咁Purana都有好多部嘅，其實就根據啲人唔同嘅程度啦。咁當然有啲人都可能會係讀呢個Shiva Purana 嘅去崇拜Shiva
嘅。And there are different instructions for different classes of people.
因為對唔同級別嘅人咧，其實都有唔同級別嘅教徒嘅。So
generally you find like that. People who are more inclined in the mode of passion and ignorance, then they will worship in a particular way.
So basically, we should stay away, and there's no point in talking to people about such. If they're committed, then.
Yeah. Tamal Krishna Goswami described how he had contact with one professor who was studying poetry which was written about glorifications of Durga.
咁，譚德基沙嘅Swami嘛，咁佢咧就曾經講過咧，佢就係遇見一個教授啊，咁呢個教授咧，咁佢咧就係讀過一個關於去榮耀呢個Durga嘅呢個咁嘅文章嘅。So
he described how this professor was coming to Bengal to attend some big festival which they were having, where they were glorifying Durga.
And he described how, you know, that so many people were intoxicated and there was killing of goats, every blood everywhere, and you know, people were all like mad people.
當去到那個場地的時候，咁佢就發覺好多人咧，佢哋咧就係你話吸食呢個麻醉劑啦，咁樣咧就係佢哋同埋殺啲羊啦，咁嗰啲羊嗰啲血咧就搞到周圍都係嘅，咁其實當時好多人咧睇嚟都好瘋狂嘅。
So often also you find where people are worshipping Lord Shiva, you will see also the influence and the motivation and intoxication.
No cleanliness, no good food, just principle. So
Lord Shiva is God, he's one of the gods of the material world. Right, he's controlling the mode of ignorance. Guna avatar. So he's controlling material, he's got some power in the material world. But in the spiritual world, Supreme Lord Krishna.
但係喺靈性世界咧，就係至尊嘅人物就係Vishnu啊，Krishna。So,
we can worship Lord Shiva. You can worship him. If those people who are actually worshiping him, if they get the real mercy of Lord Shiva, then they will be directed to his worshipable Lord.
咁其實都可以崇拜Lord Shiva嘅，咁如果佢哋係好真誠嘅，去崇拜Shiva嘅話咧，其實咧佢哋都係得到指引，指引到去至尊主嗰度咁最後。And
some, of course, they argue Lord Rama worship Shiva.
咁甚至有人咧就有啲拗叫咧，就係講就係話佢哋Lord Rama 都係崇拜Shiva嘅。When
Prabhupada was asked about this, he said yes. Lord Rama was telling Shiva, I'm going to kill your
devotee.
And Lord Rama, remember, he's playing the part of an ordinary person. He's the ideal king. He's showing the example that you should worship Lord Shiva. Lord Shiva is one of the devas of this material world.
當時因為Lord Rama咧就係以一個普通人嘅呢個形象嘅去顯示，所以佢咧亦都係要作出一個示範嘅。咁所以佢咧就係崇拜Lord Shiva，叫啲人崇拜Lord Shiva。So
for ordinary people, it's good they do some worship.
對一般人來講，他們做一些崇拜都是好事。If
they come to worship Radha and Krishna, they will not understand, they may commit offenses.
因為叫他們直接去崇拜Radha Krishna的話，他們不會明白的，他們反而會做出冒犯。Maharaja
Sijatama Prabhu, on his tour to South India and other places, he visited many temples of Lord Shiva. So
yeah.
Is that an example to follow?
Yeah.
Lord Chaitanya嘅消息時間入邊咧，就係講及佢其實都去探訪過好多Shiva嘅廟宇嘅。
Yes, we offer our respects to these devas. We go to these holy places, we offer our respects.
當然啦，我哋亦都係展示出我哋嘅尊敬嘅對於呢啲觀世音嘅。
Lord Shiva, Lord Chaitanya went to see these temples of Lord Shiva. Offered his respects, chanted the holy name. But generally, we don't eat the prasadam of the demigods.
但一般來講呢,我們呢,就不會吃那些供奉給本神人的祭魚的。
Unless it's Vishnu prasadam, which is then offered to the demigods.
反而呢,就是說我們呢,就是會將, Lord Vishnu, 的祭魚呢,是供奉給一些半神人的。
But we certainly go to the temples of the devas and we offer our respects.
其實呢,我們都可以去到這些半神人的廟宇那裡去作出我們的尊敬的。
In Malaysia, when they do Ratiyatra there, they bring the deities, we always go to the temples of the other devas and offer respects. Pujaris will come out, they will offer some puja for Jagannath. Devotees will all go in and will circumambulate the temple, offer obeisances, come out.
在馬來西亞那時候,Ratiyatra那時候,其實都會有些其他人帶了他們的神像在一起,那些Pujaris其實都會崇拜,而且人也都會
We read in 10th canto, Nanda Maharaj observing Shivratri, so that we can, devotees may also, if they like, observe Shivratri. In Mayapur, every year there's a program at the Rajpur Mandir where we have a Lord Shiva Linga there. Shiva Linga there, and we have a big program on Shivratri.
What is wrong with eating his prasad if he's a devotee of Krishna directly?
Well, we eat Krishna prasadam. A devotee, whatever a devotee eats, the devotee will eat Krishna prasadam. When we eat the remnants, that Mahamaha prasadam. Right? The remnants of a devotee is Mahamaha Prasadam, the remnants of their, which they, because they take Krishna Prasadam, then we take their remnants. And so Lord Shiva also, you know, if it's first, if it's Prasadam, which is offered to Lord Shiva, then we can.
Thanks to asking Lord Shiva on Shivratri that who is superior, yourself, as everybody says, all Indians, or Durga Devi, or Lord Krishna, as said in the Bhagavad Gita. Mm-hmm. And when I came down the temple, one of the Matajis doing book distribution, mm-hmm. she gave me a Bhagavad Gita saying, all the answers you want are in the book. Mm-hmm. And that's where the Lord says that he is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And I started coming to ISKCON thereafter. I thought, okay, that's my answer. So really, and thereafter I continuously till today prayed to Lord Shiva just to give me firm devotion and love towards serving their Lordship.
Very good. Okay.
Once Jayapataka Swami was here on Mahashivratri and he said that devotees should pray for advancement in Krishna consciousness to Lord Shiva.
Yeah.
That is only the mood of a devotee.
Okay.
就是講緊,若基琴媽德茲就講緊,他之前以前就是預見過曾經問過一個題目,就是說那些不同神的分別是不是?媽德茲,你說一下。大概,當時就是後來一個派書的媽德茲就給了一本博加牌給媽德茲,就說你所有的問題答案都在裡面,所以媽德茲就說他從此之後,他都有向書法禱告的,就希望學佛得到這個奉愛對Krishna的奉愛,是不是?
Srimad Bhagavatam ki
jai. Maharaj ki
Oh,